This is Michael, age 7. This is Candace, age 8. This is Christopher, age 7 and a half. These children and others like them will try to make you understand what they're talking about on Child's Play. And here is the host of Child's Play, Bill Cullen.
Over the left shoulder. Hi there. Hey, thank you. Oh. Oh, I thank you all very kindly. You're marvelous, and welcome to Child's Play, a game where children interpret the words that grown-ups try to guess. Let us meet our grown-ups and our players at the moment. Here is our champion. This is her 5th consecutive day. She's a lovely young thing. So far, she's won $12,800. She is Joanie Fenstermaker. Welcome back.
Thank you.
You're welcome. You have that pure, wholesome beauty of the all-American girl, Joanie. Did I tell you that?
No, thank you very much.
You're very welcome. Anything you want to say, this being your 5th and final day of eligibility?
That my dad has been with me through this, too. I wanted to make sure that...
we mentioned your mother, Rosemary.
Right.
What's your dad's name?
Roy.
Okay, Rosemary and Roy, mother and father, are rooting this young lady on. Let us say hello to her opponent. He's a charming-looking chap. You will notice him over there to Joni's immediate right. Say hello to John Osborne. Welcome, John. Well, John, because we're meeting you now for the first time, what would you like us to know about you?
Well, I'm from Odenton, Maryland.
Uh-huh.
And I have a wife and 3 lovely children, and I'm a salesman in an aluminum company.
All right, we wish you well, John. You and Joanie know each other. We're all ready to start our game. Let's show the folks at home the word we're going to be trying for right now. There's the word. Everybody sees it but our 2 players. Our people at home and our people here in the studio know what it is. I know what it is. And Christopher White knows what it is, and he's the young man who's going to begin the explanation. He's 7 and a half years old. So, Christopher, the word, if you would.
If I had one, I'd be marrying that person very soon, but I didn't marry her yet. So, if we go out together or something, and we see a friend in this elegant restaurant, and then the person says, oh, you're getting married very soon? And then they say, yeah, and I think you got the invitation too. And then the man says, did you mail them the invitation, darling?
That's very well done, Christopher. Boy, that was good. All right, that was Christopher White's interpretation of the word we're playing for. Joanie, what do you think?
Well, if you're gonna marry them very soon, is it your fiance?
Right, very good. Fiancé is the right word. Congratulations. That was a tough one. Well, John, we're going to start with you this time and see if you can't catch up. So you pay particular attention as we show the people at home and here in the studio the word. Oh, okay. This could be fun. Let's listen to the first explanation or description. Candace Feinberg, who is 8 years old, gives us this word. Candace, dear?
Well, somebody, like, if somebody has a piece of cake and you're not allowed to have cake and they're saying, oh, this is so good. Oh, too bad you can't have it. Good. Oh, I love this. That person is absolutely crazy. They're like, oh, I'm gonna kill you. And he's going, so good.
What a job. Next week, East Lynn. What a marvelous acting job that was. John, based on what Candace said, what do you think the word is?
Well, to wave some cake in front of your face, would that be to entice?
No, good word. Good word for what you heard, but not the right one. Remember, children speak, and Joanie, it's your turn to listen and see if you can't come up with this. This is David Lerner, who's 6 years old from New Jersey, working on the same word. Okay, David.
Oh, yeah, that's a good one. Suppose you have you're on a diet, and then you see all these people with chocolate eclairs, and you want to eat them, and you're like, no, I can't do this. Oh, yeah, I have to. No, I can't do this. Oh, I can't stand it. I can't stand watching them. Oh, I have to take a bite. But I can't.
Thank you, David. Oh, golly, we're getting coming up with a stock company of actors here. Well, now, Joni, what do you think?
I think it's Temptation.
It is Temptation. We have another one. It is marvelous when you stop to think that children of the age our children's are still think of temptation as it pertains to food. The score is 2-1, 2-0. Joanie is ahead. We play Child's Play until time is up. Whoever is ahead at that point wins $500 and a crack at $5,000. We'll be back right after this for you.
Weekdays are great days for great action.
He's having a great time with you, Dave. We're going to have a great contest.
Great excitement.
Isn't that great?
It looks great.
You get great answers.
I've been great. I'm thrilled to be here.
Great fun.
All-time great.
Great matchups.
Great.
Great.
Great. Great. Great.
It's a great way to spend the day.
Isn't that a great deal?
Great. Great.
Greater. Greatest.
Very nice indeed.
We're having a great time.
Daytime Buzz. It's great. Weekdays starting at 10, only on BUZZR. Let's play.
As you know, I mean, you know that, but I just say it. Okay, Joni, it's your turn to listen ever so closely now because we're going to start with you. But first of all, for the folks watching here, there's a word we're going to be playing for. See it up there? Okay, now, Tata Amari is a lovely young lady. She's been on our show quite a few times. Matter of fact, she made a personal appearance here with us some time ago. She brought her sister with her, and we're going to do a team depiction of this word. So, Joni, you listen to Tata and Mimi Amari. They're ages 7 and 6. Ladies?
It's when you go up very high in the mountains where the edge of it is, and then you go, ta-ta,
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 ta-ta.
That was good. Thank you, Tata and Mimi Amari. Well, what do you get from that, Joni?
That's an echo.
It is an echo. Boy, oh boy. We are going to have our own Shakespearean stock company here pretty soon. John, we're ready to give you a shot to start at one now. There's the word John's going to be playing for right now. We have an 8-year-old. Describe. Hey, he's good. This is a good fella because he's done a lot of ours before. Listen carefully to Sean Guerin. Sean, do the word for him.
Once upon a time, these people made this river, but these snakes got in the river and destroyed a lot of the river. So St. Patrick, who was a dirty man. He had dirt all over him. And one day, St. Patrick was walking, trotting along, and clumsiness came to him, and he fell into the river where the snakes were. But luckily, the dirt all over him, the snakes were allergic to. And that dirt killed them, and St. Patrick was the hero.
Thank you, Sean Guerin. Well, now, listening to everything that Sean said, John, do you get an idea of a word that he was trying to get across to you, remembering children speak?
What I can only get from what he said is safe.
Safe? No, that wasn't it. And we come back now to Joni, and Sean Griffin, who is 8 years old, is going to describe the same word, Joni. Sean, if you would.
Oh. That, I can speak a little of it, and you want me to? See, this is how they say yes. They go, aye, and they say a little, that when they see a little boy, they go, how you doing, me old lad? And that's all I can do.
Well, Sean, that's pretty good what you did there. All right, we had two Seans. The first one, Guerin, and the second one, Griffin. What do you get from it, Joni?
I think it's Ireland.
Ireland is the right answer. Good for you. Good for you. And I promise you that Sean Guerin will probably brush up on his St. Patrick lore there. Hey, Joni, you have quite a lead, 4-0. John, you can always catch up. If not now, you certainly can catch up in fast play. We're going to begin this one with you, Joni. First of all, here's the word we're going to be playing for. Okay, here she is back now as a solo. She dumped her sister somewhere along the line. The head of this particular acting clan, Tata Amari, 7 years old. Tata, dare please.
It's like when you're scared. Like in the middle of the night when everyone's sleeping. And I can't sleep because I feel like some sort of ghost is going, ah, so scary. I move my hands and everything. I feel so blank. I feel like, oh no. It's like, it says, we're coming to eat you. And then I'm, oh no. And I get real scared.
Thank you, Tata. Scared me. Scared me a lot. Joni, what do you think the word is?
I think if she's scared, she's frightened.
Frightened's a good guess, but not quite it. Chance for you to catch up now, John. Remember what you heard and add to it that which you're about to hear. An 8-year-old by the name of Joy Avedisian will describe it. Joy, if you would, please.
Well, one time I was playing with my friend, and then she goes, well, since Isabel left, why don't I play with you, Joy? And I go, okay. So then she plays with me. And then she goes away because the friend came back. And then I'm staying all by myself and I'm crying. And then my other friend comes up to me and she goes, why are you crying? And I go, because no one wants to play with me. And she goes, I'll play with you. And her name's Christian and she's real fat.
Brings it beside the point. I think I can safely say that last bit of information was a little beside the point. But John, what word are we looking for?
Well, if she had no one to play with her, would she be alone?
She would be, John. Well done. Okay. You did it, John. You got in there. Okay, John's score. The score now is 4 for Joni and 1 for John. When we come back to Child's Play, we shift gears, play the game for speed in the fast play round, and we'll be back with fast play right after this for you. Welcome to Too Far Away.
Raver.
Hello there.
Dawson.
Survey set.
The Zazz.
Oh, I don't mind your shedding tears of joy, but you're crying on my new suit.
The Class.
You're going to watch the telly tonight, are you?
The Long Mike.
That is absolutely correct.
The Longer Kiss.
I've gotten aroused.
2 originals, 2 hours.
The lunatics have taken over the asylum, so.
Match Game and Family Feud together again, today at 4. Only on BUZZR.
You said it very well.
Let's play.
So now, game between John Osborne, our new player, and Joni Fenstermaker, who is here for her last day of eligibility. Score is 4 for Joni and 1 for John. Fast play now. From now on, each child will be defining a different word. As soon as you recognize the word, interrupt with your signal. Each right answer will be worth 2 points. When you hear the school bell, that's when time is up. Whoever is ahead at that point wins the game, $500 and a chance at the $5,000. Good luck to you. Both of you now ready to interrupt. Here's word number 1, Zachary Castle. Zachary.
It looks like a little stick with two little horns-like things coming out. And you can put a rubber band or something on it.
That's Joni.
A slingshot?
Slingshot's the answer. 2 more points for you. Next word, Casey Hushin. Casey.
Well, they're on cars on the back of them and have numbers and...
Joni again.
A license.
Right again. Another 2 points for you. You lead 8-1. Jillian Ostreicher. Jillian, please.
If, like, say you see a lot of bees all together in, like, a group.
Yes, John.
A swarm?
No, John. Sorry, that's a wrong answer. The rest of this entire description belongs to you, Joni. Jillian, if you would.
And they just seem to be going all together one way. They have a home, and it's sort of like a little house that they stay in.
All right, Joni.
Hive.
Hive is it. Swarm was a good answer, John, but not the right one. Both ready to interrupt. Here's Carmen Leahy with the next one. Carmen.
Something you gargle.
Joan again.
Mouthwash.
Mouthwash, right. You're running up a big lead here, 12-1. Okay, now hang in there, John. Here is Layla Ortiz. Layla?
He's a little puppet. And...
John.
Pinocchio.
Right, John, you picked up two. That's it. Here he is, the demon describer, ready to interrupt, Sasha Segan. Sasha.
This large city is the capital of Greece.
Joni.
Athens.
Athens, right. Two more for you. Next word, Stacy Condor-Curry. Stacy.
It's something like if you eat ribs or something that really messy.
John.
Barbecue.
Nope. Little tiny bit of this left. It's all yours, Joni. Stacy, please.
Wipe your mouth or your hands on it.
That was a, all right.
Napkin.
That was a big clue there. Sure was, wasn't it? 16 for Joni. John has three. Here's Jeffrey Burks. Jeffrey, if you would.
His name is Josh Kaluva, and he happens to be my best one. And
that's Joni.
Friend.
Friend is the right answer, and you pick up two more. All that John's getting out of this at this point is a sore hand. Both of you ready, though. Here comes the next word. Molly Turbeville. Molly?
He rode through the town saying...
That's you, John.
Paul Revere.
You got it, John. Okay. Next word. April Armstrong. April?
My mother puts it on bagels every day.
John again.
Cream cheese.
You're hot, John. Two more. Next word, Christopher White. Christopher.
It's a dog and it has, and sometimes in cartoons, they have curly little balls on their tails. Well, there's a fret.
Yes, John.
Poodle.
You are hot, John. You're up to nine. Next word, Sarah Hinkleman has it. Sarah, dear.
You write with it?
Joni.
Pen.
No. John, a little bit of the description left. Listen real closely to what's left. Okay, Sarah.
On the top of it is an eraser.
John?
Pencil.
Right. You got another two. That's it. Time's up. Joni, you've done it again. Congratulations. Your fifth consecutive win. Well, Joni. That was a good bit there. Congratulations. Good time. I got to take just a moment of our time, if I may, to thank John Osborne, because, John, you took you a while to get started, and you really were going there at the end. You played a very good game, just started a little late. Guess that's a...
Next time.
It's better than ending a little early, which is my problem, John. We thank you ever so much, and we have some very nice gifts for you.
Thank you
ever so much. Now, you got yourself 500. We'll give you a shot at 5,000 in triple play, but right now, we're going to do this, please.
Take a look at this.
Let's play.
This is too hip for you. I'll slow it down.
Survey said...
100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600,
700 more. Hold it. Let's play. Well, now, look here. Thank you. Here it is. Big spot. Time for the $5,000 try now, and we have Rosemary and Roy Fenstermaker's little girl, Joni, up here. Her mother and father, really, they're here, and they root for her. Last chance for you, Joni.
That's right.
Let's hope you do it, because you've been with us our limit. Got 500, you just won, brings you up to 13,300. Time now to try for 5,000 in our triple play game. You know, of course, we asked our kids to write brief definitions of simple words. We took three per word, each written by a different child, A, B, or C. You have a total of 45 seconds. To come up with six of them, pay $100 a word. If you get them all, $5,000, which is a nice way to go out.
Oh, yeah.
Hope you do it. I really do.
I do too.
All right, bring in the clock. There, the clock's here and I'm gone. And now, the clock will not begin until you tell me where you want to start. Good luck. Let's see what happens.
B.
There is a worm this long.
A.
It's on a ruler.
C.
12 of them make 1 foot.
Inches, A.
Correct. A, please. You do it before you go to bed.
Brush your teeth, B.
When you talk to...
Pray, C.
Correct, C. A boy that was born after you.
Brother,
correct.
A.
A candy made from the roots of a plant.
Licorice, B.
Correct. It's like eternity or all your life.
Forever, A.
Correct. Some characters from Rock Age.
Caveman, B.
A fiction cartoon of the dinosaur age.
Fred Flintstone, C.
Correct, that's it. Flintstone, C. Isn't that nice? Oh, that's good. You, Joanie, that was nicely done. I'm here yelling, you did it. Oh, good, you had 11 seconds left. Oh, I bet your mother and father are proud of you. Here was a girl who came to us, a veritable pauper, a few days ago, wanting just enough money to have her car fixed. You leave us with $18,300. We'll be back in just a moment. Don't go too far away.
Up next, using your body to form phrases can be hazardous, but a lot of fun on Body Language. Then it's Alphabet Soup on TV with Blockbusters. Stay tuned.
Goodbye from the Joanie Fenstermaker Show. If you like kids, you love Child's Play. Goodbye.
Some of the cutting detectors receive this contact. Lightweight GE Knife slices at any angle. Stainless steel blades have serrated cutting edges. The fingertip control bar has a safety lock. Wall mounting rack is included. Take a little work out of kitchen chores. The Oster can opener citrus juicer has a power pierce and magnetic lid lifter. The cutting blade can be removed for easy cleaning, and the juicer makes pulp-free juice. A cookbook can wind down and really relax with Lipton Herbal Tea. It's a soothing blend of natural herbs, spices, and fruit. And absolutely no caffeine. It's delicious. A cassette recorder. This GE portable AC-DC cassette recorder has an automatic shutoff. AC adapter included. Great to take with you any place. And all of the children appearing on Child's Play this week receive Coleco's Pac-Man, official tabletop version of Midway's Pac-Man. Looks, plays like the real thing. Coleco's Pac-Man, the arcade game you can take home with you. Or from the Hanamex, their 35mm microflash camera, so small it fits in the palm of the hand. Built-in electronic flash, 3 settings, thumb wheel film advance, and exposure counter from Hanamex. This is Gene Woods speaking for Child's Play, a Mark Goodson television production.